Hi everyone, this is AT, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to install Microsoft SQL Server 2014 Enterprise. Now, after downloading SQL Server based on your CPU type from Microsoft website, you're going to come down here and click on Setup icon and wait for it to open. After it opened up, you're going to click on Installation, and under Installation here, you're going to click on New SQL Server Standalone Installation or Add Features to an Existing Installation, which is what we want, and then we click on it, and you can close that window as well if you want. Now here, click on Next. Check the license agreement checkbox and then click on Next. You're next. And in this page, you can uncheck this update option. You don't need it. Then click on Next. Now in this page, you might see some warnings. If anywhere during installation or here in this page, this item was a warning or its warning was on, you need to have to download Microsoft .NET framework, which I will have the link in the description. And for this firewall option, you just have to ask your network administrator, or if you're using a single server PC, you don't need to do anything. Just click on Next and go for the next page. In this page, we don't need all of these options here. We just need some of them. Management tools or management tools complete. We don't need analysis services. We don't need reporting services. We only need database engine services and its subordinating functions. Okay. Just these four or five, and we don't need anything. Click on Next. This part is actually a little tricky. If you want to have multiple instances of your SQL Server, you have to click on Named Instance in here, and you have to give it a name, which is what I'm going to do. But if you don't, just leave it as the default instance and click on Next. Now, for the next page, under Startup Type, you're gonna have to, it's better to choose Automatic, because SQL Server Agent actually helps you to get backups automatically from your database without using any third-party applications. For the next part, you're gonna have to use mixed mode authentication, because SQL Server Authentication is much more stronger. And for the educational purposes only, I will use this current user to make us login faster for our next videos to come. But you shouldn't do it if you are installing SQL Server on company servers. Now, when it added, click on Next, and everything's in order. Just click on Install and wait for the installation progress to finish. I will actually fast forward this video to the end of the installation. And meanwhile, please give me a thumbs up if you like this video, and just like this, the thumbs up. And why don't you subscribe my channel? It will actually help my channel to grow and motivates me to create new videos for you. Thank you.